My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky.
The essence of the album is everybody's high school songs with their sweethearts. The songs that they fell in love to and by and made out to for the first time. And there's a lot of nostalgia connected with all the songs on the album.
No month of May, no twinkling.
Is he getting dressed for the rehearsal?
There. My favorite song, it's hard to pick. Probably He Was Too Good to Me, which is a Rodgers and Hart song. It's so simple, but then Time After Time is exquisite. That was my song in high school with my high school sweetheart. I guess we picked songs for the album based on what sounded good in my voice. I think the greatest performances are done when the singer and the song really merge. The essence of the song and the singer. It's like if a song had a color and the singer has the color, and then you either merge complementarily, or it's in unison. And so I tried to pick the songs that had the same essence as I did. The songs like In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning. When I was a teenager, I used to listen to Frank Sinatra night and day, lying face down on my bed, with my face directly in the pillow, sobbing, imagining that I had those emotions that were talked about.
You'd be his if only he'd call.
It took a while for me to grow into the real emotions of these songs, and little by little, in increments, I began to develop a real intellectual as well as an emotional appreciation and understanding of these songs.
I think the first one we tried, in fact, was Wee Small Hours of the Morning, which is on the album, and we tried it, and I think it's the first time it just went great. And we ended up staying for an hour past we had to stay. And when it was over, she just said, "Well, that was a lot of fun. Let's do an album." What we're getting on the album is a great mixture of these old standards with a strong feeling of what Carly's about. Pretty early on in our rehearsals, Carly just kind of stopped and said, "You know, God, I forgot how singable this stuff is. I mean, it just kind of, it wants to be sung. It just, you know, the lyrics and the music just make it totally singable."
I included a song that I wrote with the help of Michael Kozarin and Jacob Brackman called What Has She Got, which is an original song, so therefore it's not a standard as such. But getting into that standard head was kind of fun, to try to write a song that would fit in with the rest of the songs on the album.
The thoughtless things he'll do will hurt him.
Something wonderful is, it's hard to even talk about it without tearing up, because that song probably has more emotional impact on me than any of the other songs on the album. Of course, it's The King and I, and one of the first musicals I ever saw.
That won't come true. You know that he believes in them.
My family was very much involved in the world of the musicals, and they took us, as soon as we were old enough to go, to Oklahoma and Carousel and South Pacific, Kiss Me Kate. And we would have family musicals, or musicals, or sort of musical evenings. Uncle Peter played the ukulele and sort of danced, and Uncle Dutch played a pretend stand-up bass where he would go, "Boom, boom, 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 boom." When we would go and see a show on Broadway, we would come home and my father would sit down at the piano and would play all the songs, and my two older sisters would learn to sing them, and we would put on the records and we'd play them over and over again until we all had learned the songs, and we danced around the living room singing the songs, and we looked in the mirror, the mirrors gesticulating, until we became the singers singing the songs. Club for the HBO special. I wish we could keep it. I wish that we could perform here. Well, they could perform here a lot, and I could come in and sit in on a song or two. It was just incredible. And then working with Harry Connick Jr. and doing the rehearsal with him and the performance with him, and realizing that we sounded as if we've been singing together for years.
I don't know why, I just do. I don't know why, I just do.
That's great. Wonderful.
Not bad, eh? For folk music? All right.
Don't take that off.
You took advantage of it.
We're at the whole time.
It's definitely hard to take this off. I've always loved doing these songs, and I've always felt more at home singing these standards, these show tunes, because as a songwriter, I'm not as good writing for my own voice as Richard Rodgers was for writing for singers' voices, or Arthur Schwartz, or Cole Porter, or people who really didn't write for themselves, and so therefore they had to think intellectually about, well, let's see, what are singers best at doing? What vowels can they hold out the best? What do they sound best doing?
Don't change your hair for me, not if you care for me. Stay.
We recorded it in 3 days. It was all live in the studio with an orchestra. All the vocals were live. I had a couple of retouches, but there, I mean, that's the concept, that it really is like a live album. I think when people hear My Romance, hear this album, that they'll feel as if they want to dim the lights, as if they want to put on something a little more comfortable, as if they want to dab a little perfume behind their ears, as if they want to kiss, make out.
Doesn't need one thing but you. My Romance.
Carly Simon talks about her brand new album, My Romance.
The essence of the album is everybody's high school songs with their sweethearts. I think when people hear My Romance, they'll feel as if they want to kiss, make out.
My Romance, Carly's heartfelt interpretation of timeless classics. A very special affair.
Sweet comic book.